Jack. I want you to open this door, and I want you to open it now. I'm quite serious, Jeff. This isn't funny. You've gone beyond the bounds of good taste and good judgment.
Now you sound like my eighth grade teacher.
Jeff, open the door.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Open Mic. Today's scheduled guest was Jeff Cameron. Unfortunately, Mr. Cameron can't be with us because he's dead.
Jeff
was a man of energy, wit, and integrity. His professionalism allowed him to rise above the daily pressures and pettiness that could affect any job.
What's going on?
You're the host, you figure it out. Ask me some questions, huh? I mean, how often do you get to interview a dead man?
You know, when the security guard...
No, don't do that, Karen. Don't you insult my intelligence. No, do it. When the security guard gets here, he will do what he always does, which is to check and make sure that the doors are locked. Just what, Karen? He will find that the doors are indeed securely locked. Next question. What's the security guard's name? Bet it's not Wayne.
Why not Wayne?
Well, he burned to death.
In your apartment.
He was dedicated to you, Karen. I don't think you know how much he worshipped you. I know that kind of obsession is not a healthy thing. But even after you fired him, he worried about protecting you. He was convinced that it was Diane who sent those snakes. That beef heart.
You sent those things. You sent the letters.
With my love always. Good old Wayne. You know, he kept up with his little personal investigation, and somehow with that tiny little mind of his concluded what you just concluded and showed up on my doorstep one day with the suggestion that I turn myself in. He showed up just before you did. I didn't want him worrying you. Technically, the fire killed him. And as it turned out, officially, the fire killed me.